All right, 10th class, let us continue with the topic. So we were discussing about GNU, not Unix. As I told you, we pronounce it as GNU, not Unix. GNU actually is a bird. Last lecture, I show you the logo of it. It's a penguin-shaped bird. And that bird signifies freedom. The bird lives in freedom. Similarly, the freedom has been incorporated here in the open source with the meaning that free to share, free to modify, free to distribute without much restrictions. Okay, clear? Now, next term is FSF, Free Software Foundation. Now, by name, it is very much clear why this foundation was set up. It was a non-profit organization, okay, and it was set up by Richard Stallman in 1985. The main purpose was to promote free softwares. You know that a few years back in our 9-10, we were having MS term. Like MS Office was there. Okay. Then CBSE, they changed the syllabus and they introduced free software, open source software. Right? Now we are having, let's say, for example, Python in 11-12. Python is open source. Very interesting programming language. Okay. 9-10, we have open source. Or 9th, we have open office. Right? So the organization is set up in order to promote the use of free softwares. Okay. These questions can come as MCQs. Like from here only, I can derive one MCQ. Who founded FSF? Richard Stallman. I am giving another MCQ question and I'll be giving options also. So you raise your hand for the answer. The FSF Foundation was developed in the year 1990, 2010, 1985, right? So from these things, these points only, you can set up your MCQs, okay? Even the case study, right? Now, next is OSI. Another full form comes, Open Source Initiative. FOSS is Free and Open Source Software. FLOSS is Free Liber Open Source Software. OSS is Open Source Software. SGML is Standard Generalized Markup Language. Daily we keep on revising the things so that we are in touch with them. And OSI is Open Source Initiative. Again, it was set up by Bruce Perens and Eric Raymond. Remember the founder's name. Bruce Perens and Eric Raymond in which year? 1998, February. What was the main objective behind setting up Open Source Initiative to promote open source softwares? Okay, to promote the use of open source softwares. And whatever terms and conditions have been developed, those terms and conditions we have to follow. Like I told you earlier also, whenever we download or install any software, any app, the first page that comes is about terms and conditions. Some clauses are mentioned and then there is a button, I agree. I agree means I am complying with all the rules, all the policies and all the standards, all the conditions, all the clauses which have been contained in that. Sometimes unknowingly we click on I agree. We never read the terms and conditions. We must read all the terms and conditions. Okay, like a few days back I was installing some software on my laptop. And the moment I download the file, immediately one message comes that it can be risky for your laptop. it was having some virus. So my laptop gave me a certain message that before installing it to read the conditions and all that. So I again uninstall it because I felt that it can be a risk. Okay. So always read the terms and conditions before downloading any app from Play Store or installing any software in your computers. Okay. So again, one question gets, who developed open source initiative? Bruce Perens, Eric Raymond. Which year? 1998. What was the main objective? To promote open source softwares. Okay. Okay. Freeware. फ्रीवेयर के बारे में तो मैं आपको सिंपल लाइंस में समझा दूं. फ्री सॉफ्टवेयर, फ्रीली अवेलेबल, ओके, बट यू कैन नॉट मॉडिफाई इट बिकॉज यू डिडंट गेट द सोर्स कोड. आपको सोर्स कोड नहीं मिलता, आपको उसकी कोडिंग नहीं मिलती कि आप उसको मॉडिफाई कर पाओ. ओके, जैसे सपोज यू डाउनलोड गूगल क्रोम, कैन यू मॉडिफाई गूगल क्रोम? Because you don't get the coding of that. You don't get the source code of that. So freeware software ki sabse important feature hai, the source code is not provided. So you cannot modify the source code. You cannot modify it. It's free of cost. You can share it. Okay. But modification is not allowed. Modify tabhi hoga jab source code milega. So here lies the important difference between open source and freeware. In open source, you have the source code, but in freeware, you don't get the source code. Modification is possible in open source, but not in freeware. Okay. World Wide Web Consortium. The term is W3C. Three here means World Wide Web. World Wide Web Consortium. World Wide Web actually is a collection of files. It's a very broader term. It contains all the standards, all the protocols, okay? All the hyperlinked files. So some standards have been set, some protocols have been set. Agar protocol ko main simple jai, अगर मैं प्रोटोकॉल को सिंपल एक वर्ड में बताऊं ना, इट मींस रूल्स. आई स्पीक वन लाइन, यू विल गेट टू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रोटोकॉल. फॉलो द रूल्स ऑफ द स्कूल, फॉलो द रूल्स एंड गाइडलाइंस ऑफ द क्लास, फॉलो द प्रोटोकॉल ऑफ द क्लास. प्रोटोकॉल मींस रूल्स. लाइक व्हेन वी आर कम्युनिकेटिंग ऑन इंटरनेट, वी आर यूजिंग इंटरनेट, वी आर एक्सेसिंग इंटरनेट, we should follow some protocol, we should follow some guidelines, we should follow some rules. Like these days, you know the situation, we have to follow the COVID guidelines. Wherever we go, we have to follow the COVID-19 guidelines. Means we have to follow the COVID-19 protocol. The rules which have been framed by the government. Similarly, some standards and some protocols, they have been fixed. They have been set up for World Wide Web. So we are to promote that. We are to use the World Wide Web. We are to use the standards to their full potential. Right? This is the main objective of World Wide Web Consortium. Okay? Then is proprietary software. It's a very important term. It was a question in the last year pre-boards. Just a minute. Proprietary software has some strong features. It is not freely available. You can't share it. You can't modify it. Source code is not available. You are bound by some restrictions. Okay. You are under some restrictions while using proprietary software. Okay. So what is proprietary software? A software which is neither open nor free. It's not open source software. It is not free software. Two features get into your mind. No distribution can be possible. No modification. If you want, you have to take special permission as you are bound by some restrictions. Source code is not available. These are the strong features of proprietary software like Windows. Agar aapko original Windows chahiye, you have to purchase it. Okay, fine. Shareware. Shareware softwares, suppose I give one very good example to you. Netflix. For 1 month, it is free. When you first time download it from Play Store, they give you 1 month free. Okay. After that, you have to make payment for it. You have to subscribe for it. Shareware software basically a software which is given for a trial period. Trial period ke liye wo free mil jata. 30 days trial period hai. Aur they give you that software. You use the software. You run the software. If you are satisfied with the features of that software, you like that software, you want to continue its use, then you have to make payment for it. Then you have to make payment for it. Okay, clear? Like some games are there. You may get as a trial period to run the game for 3-4 days. If you like the game, you have to purchase it. Right? Then copylefted software. Copylefted, bahut broad term hai. In the clear lines, clear meaning, I tell you what is copylefted. I use the software, I modify the software because I was having source code and I was bound by some terms and conditions. Agar maine us software ki koi version release ki hai, koi usko modify karke uski dusri copy banai hai, to us copy par bhi wo same terms and conditions aayengi jo original pe thi. It must be comply with all the terms and conditions, one way or the less, on all the versions that you have created. That is copylefted software. So a free software whose distribution terms ensures that all copies or versions carry same or less same distribution terms and conditions. Ek cheez hoti hai, permissive. Okay, permissive means totally free. No obstacle, no restrictions. One thing is copylefted. Copylefted means if you are releasing this, if you are using someone else's source code, main kisi ka source code use kar raha hu modify karne ke liye, modify karne ke baad maine uska copy release kiya, to mujhe bhi wo source code dena padega apna. I too have to provide the source code. If I am using someone else, I have to give my own source code also. Okay? Now comes the most important topic, bit technical, but be very alert in this topic. Open source licenses. Okay, I have a general question. Let me see how much you are aware about the environment. Raise your hand. What is the use of driving license? A simple general life question I have asked. Raise your hand, use your brain, tell me. What is the use of driving license? I start from the very live example, driving license. Raise your hand. You are 10th class child. This much, so you are very much aware about the use of driving license. Yes, Dhavnesh. Authenticity of citizen that you are eligible to drive car, scooter, Activa, bike. Okay. Anything, anybody else, Harshdeep? Yeah, that is what I said. Yes, Jay. You are not, no fine is imposed on you. No penalty is imposed on you. It protects you from the fine. Okay. Okay. So generally, you all know the meaning of driving license. Authentication, and it provides you certain benefits. If you are driving a car and you are driving without license, it is considered to be negative and you can be imposed fine by the traffic police because you are disobeying the orders, disobeying the protocol. On the contrary, if you are having driving license and you are driving, if the policeman checks you, stops you, checks you, you can show the license. That means you have full authority, authenticity to drive that vehicle. You are obeying the rules of traffic. You are obeying the guidelines given by the government. You are abide by the rules and you are following the rules. As a citizen of India, you are to follow the rules, regulations framed by the government. ठीक है, आधार कार्ड, आधार कार्ड इज अगेन योर ऑथेंटिसिटी बीइंग अ सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया. सिमिलर इज द रोल ऑफ ओपन सोर्स लाइसेंस. लाइसेंस एनेबल्स और हेल्प्स द यूजर टू फ्रीली शेयर द सॉफ्टवेयर, फ्रीली मॉडिफाई द सॉफ्टवेयर, freely distribute the software. It provides certain benefits to the user of open source software. What are the benefits of the license? The license that comply with open source definition, as they allow softwares to be freely modified or shared. License provides some benefits. First, easy for others to contribute to a project without taking any special permission. Like I am, like these three girls, they want to give help to me. They want to contribute in the project which I am doing, which I am undertaking. I am developing a project. They want to help me. They can help me. They don't have to take any special permission for that. Okay. I am the original creator. So my rights are protected. No third person can claim that this project has been developed by him, not me. Irrespective, I am the original creator. So by law, I have the right over my work. Got it? It protects you as original creator. What is original creator? What do you mean by, in general sense, the meaning of original creator? Yes, Prabhupada. Yes. Bilkul. Aapne ek paragraph banaya. Aapne khud likha hai. Poem le lo. Shairi le lo. Theek hai? Aapne ek poem likhi hai. It has been created by you. So you have right over it. You are the original creator of it. It is not that you have copied from somewhere else. Wo to fir plagiarism ho gaya na, agar copy hogi to. Right? It ensures that creator gets some credit for his work. Like suppose Rahul has composed a very good poem. Okay? And he has composed himself. Total his ideas, his thoughts, nothing he has copied. So we should appreciate him. He should get credit for the work he has done. He should be praised. Okay. It also ensures that others do not claim the work of original creator as their own work. Like Rahul composed the poem, later on Aryansh can't say that this is my poem, this is not Rahul's poem. I am the creator, Rahul is not the creator. Okay? The benefits of license are clear. Now we have to start four license. Sorry, 1, 2, 5. 5 license we have to do. GPL, lesser GPL, BSD, MIT, Apache. GPL, lesser GPL, BSD, MIT, and Apache license. Okay. The most important is GPL, General Public License. General Public License. Online class, am I clear with the concepts up till here? Are you getting everything? Okay, thank you for the feedback. So I have chalked out for you people in a very simple points. Okay. So GPL stands for General Public License. GNU GPL. GNU GPL. Okay. Most common, most popular license. It provides lot of rights to the user. Wide variety of rights have been given. You can freely share. You can copy. You can distribute. You can modify. Okay. And any kind of modifications you can do. And if you are distributing it, you can charge some fees for it. So all these rights, they have been provided under GPL. Okay. This can also come as case study or as MCQ. Like I tell you, which of the following rights are provided by GPL? A option, user can copy the software. B option, user can distribute the software. C option, user can charge fee to distribute. D, all above.
All above.
Again, one MCQ. Listen the statement carefully first. GPL license provide very less rights to the user. True, false?
False.
You know, true and false also come as MCQ sometimes. Okay. So GPL is clear to all of you. Aise MCQ bana ke maine aapko ye taiyar karwa dene. So you will be very much familiar with all the license. Now comes lesser GPL. From name, very much clear. Less rights as compared to GPL. Okay. So it provides lesser rights. Now, what actually the main feature of lesser GPL is? The free software, when used, it can be incorporated both as free plus proprietary. Okay. It can have both free and as well as proprietary software. Both can be incorporated. Right? In lesser GPL, the requirements that you have to release software extensions has been removed. Some restrictions have been removed, but rights are still less as compared to the original GPL, the upper GPL that you have started. BSD, Berkeley Software Distribution. The full form of BSD is Berkeley Software Distribution. PPT is visible clearly, na? Okay, okay, okay. So it's a family of permissive free software license. Just in the previous lecture, I told you the meaning of permissive. Okay. As a student, tell me the very simple meaning of permissive. Let me see how much you are good in English. Yes, Khushi. You require permission. No. Permissive. He is very permissive. He is of very permissive nature. Free. Apni dhun ka. Without any botheration. Okay. Fewer restrictions on distribution of software. If you want to distribute, you can distribute provided you have very few restrictions on that. BSD is again of two types, new BSD or modified BSD. Now, here you will come across two terms, copyright and disclaimer. Copyright, already I have told you in the previous lectures, the right granted by law for any artistic or any creative work done by you. What is disclaimer? Okay, before that, I make you more familiar, more easy. What is the meaning of claim? I can claim this. Collect, claim your reward. Collect, take your reward. You are having authority to take your reward. You are liable to take your reward. You are liable to receive your reward. What is disclaim? Any, suppose I have created one document and I give it to you. Later on, I disclaim it. Any error occurs. If there is any printing mistake, any grammatical mistake in the document, I am not liable for it. Now you get the meaning of disclaimer? No, still not. I created one case study paragraph, a worksheet I created, and I gave it to you. One copy, I gave it to you. But later on, I disclaim it that if there is any error in any line, might be some grammatical mistake, I am not liable for it. Meri koi galti nahi. Na hi main uske liye zimmedar hoon. Na hi main uske liye responsible hoon. I don't take responsibility. I am free from it. I have given to you, now I am free. Okay? It may contain some error, but I am not liable for it. That is disclaim. Okay, third, endorse. What is endorse in general meaning? I endorse this property to this person. Endorse. To give, to hand over, legally to hand over. Okay, so let us start the meaning of new BSD license. BSD is Berkeley Software Distribution. Okay, I think the bell, lecture is over.